when you start talking about blue water versus green water versus brown water, and you start talking about color changes, you know, you come out of a river, and typically, even if the river's clear, it's going to be a brown water, it's going to be fresh water. When it hits that salt water, a lot of things happen. That fresh water will slide across the top, and it'll create all kinds of different color changes. But the reason that the fish relate to it, there's oxygen level differences, there's salinity level differences, there's temperature changes, and then of course there's visibility. I mean, there's some fish, you know, when we were on some of the shorter rigs in the shallower water, shallow relatively speaking, you know, 600 to 1,000 feet, you get more sharks. You know, they tend to like, especially, you know, the requiem sharks, the coastal sharks, tend to like more of that brown water, even if it's up on top. A little bit more murky gives them more opportunity to feed. Get into yellowfin tuna, yeah, they'll hang out in that area, but we've dropped cameras down when it looks kind of green on top or brown on top. You drop it down 100, 150 feet, it's cobalt blue because you've got that salt water coming in the loop current that's catching underneath it. But when you show up and you actually see the color change go from, you know, what you might consider a river water, which is can be a mud brown or a windblown brown, and then it starts to go kind of a green when you get the infusion of the salt and you kind of go a little bit more brackish, then you start getting to a blue, then you can even have a couple of changes on the blue. The blue can go from, like I said, just a blue color to a cobalt blue color to where it's almost electric, and that's when you really see the good offshore color.